of mental toughness to get through the tests and tribes on Survivor. Matt Tarrant made it to the last five on the show. And when the tribe had spoken finally, he went back to what he does best. He's a mentalist and a magician, I was going to say musician, and his shows have won awards at the Adelaide Fringe over the past 5 years. And we've grabbed him off the stage this morning so he can show us some tricks. Welcome, buddy. Hey.
Thank you.
Welcome.
You're a mentalist, so what do you do? You make people do things?
Yeah, so we do things like mind reading, looking body language reading, a lot of psychology in it as well, so all these different kind of things.
Where do you learn something like that?
I'm a magician, so magicians, like, we're really strange in that we
share. Have you got a rabbit in here?
There's. I was asked that on the way in, and no, there's no rabbits. That's why I look probably a little bit more casual than most magicians as well. So there's no, like, sequin dresses, no dancing
girls. No doves. No doves shoved up your front.
There's not a lot of room to hire doves anywhere. So, yeah, so it's jeans. A little bit more natural. So, yeah, it's a little bit different than what you'd expect from most magicians.
All right, so you've got this magic box here.
Yeah, well, it's not even just a magic box. It's just a cardboard box that I've got there, and I don't even want to touch or go near that box.
It's very plain. Yeah. I would like a little more embellishment.
Next time.
Okay.
Next time. But there is something special in that box, just actually for you, Denise, as well. But
for me?
Yeah, for you, but we won't get to it just yet.
It's a lime.
It might be. But what I need to do, there is something special in this box for you guys. And I wanted to create a trick which you will have no idea how this works. In fact, tonight when you go to sleep, well, you try to go to sleep, you won't be able to.
It'll haunt my dreams.
You will literally try to work out how this works and you will have no idea. Now, for this to work, all I need is six numbers.
Okay.
I need a number between 1 and 40. Now, there is just one other thing about this number. You can't have the same number twice. So I need a number from each of you, between 1
and 40. And I'm going to tell you,
you can say it out loud so everyone can hear it at home
28.
As well. 28. So 28. So 28 is your number.
Between 1 and 40. Not 28.
But make sure it's not a number that I could know that you were going to think of as well. So make sure it's not a number that's that special to you. Just a random number between
11.
1 and 40. 11. Okay, so 11. 11.
17.
17.
A lucky softball number.
The number 17. You sure about 17?
Yeah.
Okay. Joe?
Now,
is that a bad number?
Because I want this to haunt my dreams, I'm not going to pick my favourite number because that's what you just said. So I go and say 27.
27.
Ooh. Which just popped into mind.
I would hate for you to regret that later on tonight, but you're happy with 27?
I don't know! Yes.
27.
Yes.
I'm going to go 3, which is my lucky number.
3? Oh. Okay, cool. But I couldn't have known that was your lucky number.
Sorry?
I couldn't have known that was your lucky number.
No.
And I need one more number.
That's coming from Nicole.
Okay, cool.
Where are you? Nicole, what's yours?
Mine's 25.
Oh, it's a lot closer to each other.
We've got 3, 11, 25, 27, 28, and 17.
Good.
You should be the mentalist.
Can we actually just get a round of applause for the guys for those numbers as well, especially to the people behind us?
Woo! So, go numbers!
It's a tough job, I know, but I just want to be super, super clear and obvious with everyone at home watching as well. We haven't set anything up. I haven't told you
nothing.
To say
We've
or
done
think
nothing.
Of a number. We're certain of that. And even at home, I haven't said anything about this number.
Scouts on
You're not going to pull our numbers out of that box.
I haven't touched that box or gone near that box.
No, you haven't.
In fact, Denise, I want you, there's something inside this box just for you.
Is it alive?
I want to open that lid for you so you
can
see.
I don't have to eat a cockroach or anything, do I?
Can you see what that is?
It's a tax lotto ticket, isn't it?
Can you take that out for me? And everyone else can see that is just an empty box. No. It's a lottery ticket.
Yeah, I thought it was.
And on that ticket are some numbers.
No way!
Can you just do me a favour and one at a time, nice and slowly for me, nice and dramatically, read out those numbers.
But we'll do bingo. If it's your number, put your hand up.
So 3, 11, 17, 27.
Oh, bullshit.
28. And 25.
Oh my God!
That is.
Wow!
Do you want to go to the Melbourne Cup with me this year?
Yeah. Have a look at that.
So hang on a second, does that mean we're in a syndicate? We all get to share the earnings?
Unfortunately, it's not a winning ticket, but it is the right number.
Oh my God.
Show that to the screen.
And it's actually been printed out.
Yeah.
What's the date?
Sorry, here we go.
Now listen.
Here you go, have a look.
Hang on. How do you do it?
Well, the draw date is in January 2014, so unfortunately we've missed the jackpot. I do not know how you could possibly have found that.
Matt.
Or got that.
You're awesome.
Yeah.
Amazing. Yeah. Amazing. amazing.
I hope it keeps you awake tonight, at least.
Oh. Can I just, as well, can we get a shot of your assistant in the audience? There he is. Quick, just turn, there he is, our assistant. Oh, here he is.
Wow.
It's, hey? I love, like, this is the new face of magic.
It is.
No girls. No girls in sequined bikinis. It's a man
it's
with
guys
a
and beards. Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Now Matt is performing until March 19 at the Adelaide Fringe in Gluttony. For details and tickets, you can go to gluttony.com. Sorry, .net.au. Matt, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you so much. Wow.